Hi everyone, this video is going to demonstrate reverse methods in AutoTURN. AutoTURN is used confidently to analyze road and site design projects, including intersections, roundabouts, bus terminals, loading bays, parking lots, or any on-off street assignments, including vehicle access checks, clearances, and sweep path maneuvers. It is clear that the reverse maneuvers are one of the most important aspects of vehicle simulation. AutoTURN continues to improve this functionality by adding new methods for reversing vehicles. In this drawing, I am going to go through reverse vehicle maneuvers a semi-trailer can perform at this industrial site with loading bays and parking stalls. The following reverse maneuvers will be performed: straight backing, alley dog backing, and offset backing. I will be highlighting the key features AutoTURN has to make the creation of these maneuvers as efficient as possible. To get started, the units are going to be set to match the drawing, and here they are scaled to feet. While I have program settings open, I am going to go to the next category, which is display options, and check off vehicle angles when dragging. This is a personal preference I have while doing reverse maneuvers. I'm going to select OK now to continue. Next, we need to select the design vehicle that we wish to use for our analysis. To do that, I am going to click the Vehicles button, where I can select the vehicles of interest. For this demonstration, I am going to select the WB62 semi-trailer under the AutoTURN 2018 vehicle library. I am going to click OK to set this as a current vehicle. First, let's consider a truck coming from the main road, heading north, and delivering supplies to warehouse number 1. To drive, I can simply click on the type of driving path of interest. In this case, the 2D arc path is being selected. I can either left click to place it and manually set the orientation with the cursor, or I can click the pick geometry button within the Smart Path Tools interface. In this case, I'm going to click pick geometry and align the vehicle to the lane lines. To set the WB62's starting direction heading north toward the lot entrance, I'm going to left click once more to place the vehicle's start point in the right lane. As the truck approaches the entrance, it is going to turn wide and drive along the side of warehouse number 1. On the east side of warehouse number 1, there are 5 angled loading docks, all of which are preoccupied except for the second stall. Hence, the driver will have to back up and park the trailer in between loading dock number 1 and loading dock number 3. This is known as the straight backing method. The semi-trailer will need to drive forward in the loading bay area until the trailer is aligned with the stall. Typically, a minimum of at least 1 vehicle length space is required between the loading dock and the farthest vehicle position. Now we are ready to reverse the vehicle straight into loading dock number 2. Reverse within the simulation can be initiated by either dragging the vehicle backwards or clicking the reverse icon within the Smart Path Tools interface where it says Reverse Arc Path. Notice how earlier, while the vehicle was traveling forward, this label was previously showing Forward Arc Path. As I move the vehicle back, I am essentially leading the path with the trailer. The software refers to this as a pull method because the trailer is being pulled from the back. With the simulated path drawn out, again we can see the substantial amount of space required for the semi-trailer to be aligned with the parking stall. The next reverse method I am going to demonstrate is alley dog backing. This will be done by reversing the semi-trailer into one of the stalls west of warehouse number 3. In order to get set up, I am going to modify my original sweep path simulation. This can be done by clicking Continue Simulation within the Edit panel and then clicking on the Trace Path. Basically, clicking any area of the block will actuate this command. The traced steps can be undone by either clicking on the previous vehicle's position or clicking Undo on the Smart Path Tools interface. A nice starting point will be roughly 90 degrees from the orientation of the stalls. Therefore, the semi-trailer is going to be initially brought along the front of warehouse number 3. Same as I did with the straight backing method, I am going to drag the vehicle backwards in reverse arc path and perform a 90 degree turn into one of the stalls. I want to note that while using the reverse arc path, the alignment is dependent on how accurate the cursor placement is. Something I can use instead is the reverse corner path, which can be toggled within the Smart Path Tools interface. This will ensure a precise alignment with the stall. First, I am going to undo the trace steps again to get back to the initial approach. With this tool, I can specify the sweep angle. In this case, I am going to click Select Sweep Angle and set it to be aligned with the orientation of one of the stalls. The software reacts immediately, and with the reverse corner path feature, it is possible to perform a precise alley dock backing into one of the stalls. I'm going to left click to place a vehicle in the middle stall. We can see with the alley dock method, it did require a considerable amount of space in the lot to account for the large truck outswing. The final parking method I want to demonstrate is offset backing. For this particular scenario, I want the semi-trailer to reverse from the main road into driveway A, which is on the west side of warehouse number 2. This is a much tighter situation. First, I am going to set the start point by clicking Generate Arc Path, aligning the vehicle to the lane marking geometry and placing it in the right lane. It is going to travel in reverse toward driveway A. If I were to perform alley dock backing with the reverse corner path tool like I did in the previous example and have the swept path angle set to the driveway, we can see that the vehicle drives over the curb and into oncoming traffic. This is due to the large outswing of the truck, and it would require a couple of warehouse workers to halt traffic on both sides in order to have the vehicle back up safely. It would still be considered the pull method within the software because the trailer is being pulled from the back. Instead, I am going to perform offset backing. Within the Smart Path Tools interface, I am going to check off steer from first part. The software now recognizes the maneuver as a push method because the trailer is now being pushed from the tractor instead of being pulled. An experienced driver in this scenario will first back up roughly to 3/4 of the trailer length straight. Next, the steering wheels are cranked completely to the left, and as a result, the trailer moves to the left in reverse. We can see that the angle between the tires and the semi-truck is 40 degrees. This is the maximum steering angle. As I slowly back up the steering wheel cranked hard to the left, I am gradually increasing the articulating angle to around 20 degrees, which is less than half of the maximum articulating angle. The steering wheel is then straightened, and the semi-truck continues to move back in a straight line until the articulating angle reaches around 30 degrees, and such that the trailer is aligned into driveway A. Now slowly the driver reduces the articulating angle between the truck and the trailer to align this trailer and the truck straight into the parking lot. This is how an experienced driver would have done this reverse maneuver in order to minimize a front outswing. Unlike before, the semi-trailer did not drive into opposing traffic. Hence, by using the offset backing method, we can control this trailer angle and position to create a simulation close to what a driver would have done in real life. Thank you for watching our how-to video on performing reverse vehicle maneuvers for a semi-trailer. In this video, we covered straight backing, alley dock backing, and offset backing. We hope this video has been helpful and informative, and you have learned something new today. If you enjoyed this video, please check out our playlist with more videos on similar topics. These videos go into more depth and provide more insights and detailed analysis on vehicle simulations using AutoTURN. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel to stay updated on our latest videos. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them in the comments section below. Thank you again for watching, and we'll see you in our next video.